sufficient English books for the students. Yep. So when the parents came to see me, we decided to have a press conference. I called the school and I said I wanted to verify the authenticity of this news coming from the parents. Is it true? They say, yes, it's true. We have insufficient English books. Now, 2 days before our press conference, the English books miraculously all appeared. And suddenly the issue was resolved in school. When you have bilingual classes, teaching of maths and science in Dwi Bahasa, like what is happening in certain schools today, you will create a lot of bilingual confusion for the schools. And as a result, you have what we have, like a ministry of a government ministry having funny English translation on your website. I think you have heard of it on the clothes that poke the eyes. Things like that. The ministry cannot get it right, and they try to do it, try to create this in the school. It's really, really going to affect our children. Saying, without vision, the people perish. Unfortunately, we have too many visions in this country. One Prime Minister comes along, for Wasan 2020. Another Prime Minister comes along, one Malaysia. So the people are really confused. We are so close to 2020, nobody talks about 2020 anymore. And that is why Education Ministry must not fall into the hands of politicians playing politics, because this will affect our school. And without vision, our children have no clear direction. Our parents do not know how to send our kids to national schools anymore because of this. Difficult decisions cannot happen in school. Our education system and our schools are not a playground for our education minister. So hands off our school system. Stop politicking and focus on governing. Because if he cannot do it, he can give up that post. Many people can do the job better. In the national school system, our school, a lot of private schools, enrollment have already been pre-booked many years in advance. In Sriwijaya, enrollment has been fully booked for one school up to 2015. Now, many of us, especially young parents like me, cannot afford to send my kids to private school. If I want to send them to private school, I have to start saving before I even conceive her. And so as a concerned parent in Malaysia, I have to record my plea to the Education Minister today, reinstate PPSMI and at least give parents the option to choose what is best for their children. Yay! My parents have spoken up what is best for me, and your face will be featured. Your children will remember you of having done what is right and having done what is right for them. So thank you so much for creating history and, most importantly, speaking up for the best of this nation. Thank you very much.
Good afternoon, good morning, ladies and gentlemen. Good morning to all parents and children who came here today. Yes, I'm not a parent that I know of. So, when I remember when I attended the gathering with Hanayo at the USJ school, some of the parents asked, hey, what are you doing here? You're not a parent. Yeah, that's it. Well, I told them, I represent all the future parents of Malaysia. And as Malaysians, I think we have a slight grasp of Malaysian history, don't we? When we were granted Merdeka back in the 31st of October, August 1957, we were known as the Golden Peninsula. We had the second most educated population in the whole of Asia. We were a country rich in resources. We had tin, we had petroleum, we have mines, we have plantations, but our greatest resource was our human resource. But how the mighty have fallen. From having the best universities, the best schools, the best education system in Asia, we are here today where 65-year-old taxi drivers can speak better English than a 23-year-old taxi driver. You go to any old man in the kampung, he'll speak to you in immaculate English. You go to a marine pit, saya tak faham English. What has happened? Everybody mentioned, every education minister who stepped up tinkered with the education system. Since the mid-90s, things have gone worse and worse and worse. Where are we headed? That 50 years from now, or even 10 years from now, your kids will even have a proper future to look forward to. And the first and last battleground lies in education. I think we all have a vision for Malaysia. We have a vision that our great nation can truly be great, not just in words, but in fact. And we have all the building blocks to make it happen. As a nation, if you look around the whole world today, which are the countries that have the most potential? Of course, we are not a big country, so we cannot compare with the US or Russia. But if you look into the future, China, India, and Indonesia are the countries that will show humongous growth. And we have the population to capitalize on all their successes. And what are we doing here? We're here bickering among ourselves, playing politics. So I say this. I say that the education ministry, the education minister, does not know what he's doing. And if you do not know what you're doing, return the decision making back to the parents. Every parent here, you represent 100 parents who are not here today. Go back and spread the word and tell them that parents are the ones who will make the decisions for the future of their own children. So I hope you continue with this fight, because my future children's future will be on your hands as well. So continue the fight. We'll support you as much as we can. And I think I've pledged about 1,005 for this event. So we'll be waiting for the invoice. Thank you very much.
Ladies and gentlemen, we are here again is to tell the government, please listen to us.